How excited are you for tonight's event?
I'm so excited. This is such a historical place, and I love live music and the Philharmonic and this wonderfully talented singer. I can't wait to see her live. I also sing and perform, so just to be here is exciting.
There really is something special about the Royal Albert Hall. How would you describe its magic? Because it is a unique venue in so many ways.
I think because it's such an integral part of UK music, and it's just been here for so long, and so many wonderful things have come from here. And I don't know, I grew up listening to the classical music with my parents, the Proms, and so it holds a special place in my heart and many other Brits and people around the world. So I listened to the Los Angeles Philharmonic recently, and I can just say it's the most moving, just to hear that music live. It's just, you can't beat it. You can't, listening to it on a computer or headphones is not the same as live. It's just, you can't beat live music.
Can you talk a little bit about what you particularly like yourself about Valeriya's music?
I think she's brave. I think she's absolutely stunning. She's a superstar, and I think I'm excited. I don't know much about her, but what I saw about her online was very impressive. So I'm in for a treat, hopefully. Well, I just finished working on a TV show in New York called Person of Interest for CBS. And a couple of movies, but I come from the whole theatre world. So you can look out for me on Blackish on ABC, the new comedy series, and then Person of Interest, I've just finished. And a couple of other little indie movies are floating around the festival circuit. So lots is going on.
What have you been doing on Person of Interest?
I can't say too much about it because it's quite a big story. I'm playing an MI6 agent who's a spy. And it's a dream role because I kind of grew up with Bond and stuff. So I got to do all the things a boy likes to do, shoot guns and, you know, run around and throw Russians over my shoulder and just lots of fun stuff. So, yeah, it was awesome. Yeah, it's a new show on ABC called Blackish. And I'm super excited. It just got picked up for a whole season. And it's I'm playing a rather funny role in the show. And my character name is Sex, which is kind of a funny character name. And apparently I'm sex personified. So that's all I can really say about it.
What's the general premise of the show? What's the kind of concept of the series?
Blackish is about a family in Los Angeles who are living in a very white neighborhood and just it's like the Crosbys. It's a hilarious show. I mean, I've watched the first few episodes they've started airing. I come in mid-season, but it's a really fun show. I don't know if it starts airing in the UK. It's a huge hit in the States, so I'm sure it'll be here soon.
Are we going to see you back on a live stage anytime soon? Is that something you'd like to do?
I would absolutely love to be back on stage. The last thing I did was 2 years ago. It was a play called Entertaining Mr. Sloan. But I did, you know, shows in London, We Will Rock You and Fame and all that stuff. So I'm just waiting for a period where it's the right decision to do stage. So hopefully sometime next year, maybe I'll be back on stage.
Looking forward to the concert?
Yes, I am. Really excited. It's going to be good. A bit different, but it's going to be great.
What do you think makes the Royal Albert Hall such a special venue?
Well, it's just iconic, really. It's probably one of the most famous halls in the world. So it's a privilege to be invited here tonight. It's a beautiful place. So yeah, I'm really having a good time already, and it hasn't even started yet.
And have you ever had the pleasure of hearing the Royal Philharmonic perform before? Are you excited about that?
No, I haven't. So this is a first time for me. I'm really, really, really excited. It's going to be so much fun. It's really, really good to be here.
When you're not celebrating here tonight, what are you working on yourself at the moment?
I am recording my first album at the moment at Abbey Road Studios. So I'm really, really busy with the music, writing lots of songs, working with some amazing people. So I'm coming out next year, my first album. So that's just, it's going to be incredible. But it's a really busy time at the moment, just getting it all prepared.
We can imagine. Now, for fans, what can we expect from that first album? For people who aren't familiar with you, perhaps, how do you describe your sound, what they can expect from the album overall?
Yeah, very soulful, a lot of depth. I would say it's going to be quite upbeat. You can have a dance to it, but it's also going to be quite emotional, and songs that I've written, you know, myself. It's going to be a bit of a mixture, but I think people are going to be surprised with my voice to how I look, because I have a very different sound to the way I look. So I'm looking forward to people hearing my music and seeing their reactions to it.
You mentioned you've been writing songs. Is there a particular track you've been working on that you're most excited for fans to get a chance to hear?
Yes, there is. There's a song we've been working on called Lose My Mind, which is probably going to be my first single that we're going to release in the new year. So I'm really excited about that. It's a real good feel-good song. It's got a lot of emotion, but it's like it just makes you feel good every time I listen to it. It's great. So I'm really looking forward to everyone to hearing that one.
And who or what inspired that track?
I would say Paloma Faith inspired that track. I love her music. I love her voice. But I would say maybe a bit of Paloma Faith, a little bit of Ellie Goulding. So yeah, it's a mix. But hopefully it'll be quite different to, you know, it won't be mimicking anyone else. It will just be me and something quite fresh and new.
You mentioned people being surprised about the sound of your voice when they see you.
Yeah.
Is that a challenge, or do you enjoy kind of supplanting people's expectations, perhaps?
No, I enjoy it, actually. I think it's just, it's nice because people's reactions are always, that it's very unexpected, my voice, to how I look. So I think it's nice sometimes for that element of surprise. I've got a really low, soulful tone and a lot of depth to my voice, and I think some people aren't quite expecting that. I think they expect me to have more of a pop voice. So yeah, I like it. I like being a bit different. It's nice. I just hope that everyone else loves it.
Are you looking forward to the concert?
Yeah, I can't wait, actually. This is something that I've not really been to anything as big as this. So yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Excited.
The Royal Albert Hall's a really special venue. Why do you think that is?
I don't know, I just think the name. I mean, it's such a massive venue and so many big people have performed here in the past. I think that the name just the name comes along with it and everyone just gets excited, basically.
Of course, everyone gets excited about X Factor. Looking back on your own experiences, what were the highlights for you?
The highlights, obviously, were from getting as far as I did to judges' houses. I mean, I didn't expect to get that far. Another highlight, which wasn't really a highlight, was getting pooed on by a bird in front of Mel and Emma, which was quite eventful. Yeah, a bit embarrassing. But yeah, just getting as far as I did, it was a great experience. I've never experienced anything like that in my life, and performing at Wembley in front of 5,000 people, you know, you don't get to do that. So yeah, it was really good. Obviously, I've watched each show, all the live shows. I've spoke to the lads, because obviously I've kept in contact with Paul and Jake. And I spoke to Paul before the show last week, you know, wishing him good luck and what have you, and congratulating him on how well he did on the first week. So yeah, I've kept in touch and keeping tabs on it. Yeah, so here it goes. I think a lot of people, because you always get the people in the final, like, who might not necessarily have the best voice here at the competition, but that's X Factor, that's the whole part of it. It's not the voice, basically. It's not a singing competition. It's the X Factor. It's everything. You've got to be able to entertain, have the lot, everything going on. So, yeah, obviously, there's some people in the final who might not be as well as others vocally, but they make up for it entertainment-wise, like Stevie Richie. I mean, I think he's amazing. Me, I think he's absolutely hilarious. I wait every week for him to come on just to see what he's going to do. So, yeah, he's really good.
I think only Stevie could rickroll the entire nation.
Yeah, I think there's only someone like Stevie who could do it like he does. I mean, he stayed in the first 2 weeks. He's doing well, so he's doing something right.
I know it's a hard one, but who for you at the moment is the front runner? Who do you think could be your overall winner?
I think if I had to pinpoint, I don't know, I think it's definitely going to be an all-boy final. I think it's going to be Paul and Andrea in the final. I wouldn't like to say who's going to win it. But
the girls are not that bad as well, Lauren and that?
The girls are good. I mean, I love Lauren Platme. I love Steph as well before she went out, but vocally I think Lauren's like the strongest in her category. So I think it's going to be, for me, the last two, maybe. I don't know. There's three out there in the final. Three in the final. Probably Lauren, Andrea and Paul then for me, yeah.
I mean, I know it's a big question, but do you think these kinds of reality shows help or hinder young artists overall?
I think in the past, people's perception of getting to a place where I got at Judges' Houses, I mean, people see that as it being the end and that it hinders your career in the future, but I really don't think it is. One example is my manager manages another artist called Karen Harding. She went to X Factor last year, only got to boot camp, and she's now signed to one of the biggest labels in the world right now, and she's got a single coming out in December, so I definitely don't think it does. I think now people have started to get used to that. You come off the show, it's only good, it's only bettering you as an artist, really, I think. So yeah, I think it's only the start for me. I've got loads of stuff going on now, so yeah. I've been recording in Sweden some of my own songs. I've just put a taster of one of the tracks that I've been doing in Sweden onto YouTube. So if you check me out on YouTube, search Danny Dearden, you'll be able to see that. I've done a video to that song as well. I've got loads of covers up, and I'm just going to continue writing, get some more songs under my belt, and see where we go from there.
really am looking forward to the concert. I'm really, really excited. Classical music is my absolute favourite. I grew up with classical music. My dad introduced me to classical music as a very, very young child, and I started out learning the piano and everything, so it's really, really dear to my heart. And also the Royal Albert Hall is my favourite venue in the whole entire world, so super, super excited, yeah.
Why is the Royal Albert Hall your favourite venue?
When I was about 12, my uncle brought me here for the first time, and it was during the day, so there was nobody else here, and we were allowed to have a look around. And we looked, went right up to the very top and looked down on the stage, and he said to me, "Wouldn't you love to come and watch a concert here one day?" And I said, "Uncle, I'd love to come and play a concert here one day." So it's always stuck out in my mind, and I love the acoustics in here. It's fantastic.
Of course, the Royal Philharmonic is one of our proudest assets. Have you heard them before, and how excited are you about them?
I'm really excited about hearing the Royal Philharmonic. I haven't heard them before. Just absolutely, yeah, I really can't wait.
What about Valeriya? Are you a fan of her music? I mean, she's obviously an international musical icon.
She is an international music icon, and I'm not entirely familiar with her work, but I hear that it's going to be an amazing show, so I'm really looking forward to it. Yep, the big reunion was huge for us. It put us back together, and we've been gigging and touring ever since. We've actually just released our own new EP with 6 brand new tracks on it, and we're likely to be recording a new album next year as well. So lots of things going on, totally out of the blue. Who would have thought 15 years later that we'd be back, but we are, and I'm, you know, enjoying it, so it's great.
And is there a particular track on that 6-track EP that's especially special for you?
There's a track called "The Stars Are Ours" on the EP, which is the single, actually. So it's my favourite song on there. Yeah. I think the EP is probably a nice link to a nod towards the past, a nod towards what Bewitched used to be. You know, so still pop, and it's got the Irish music, and also a nice link to what Bewitched is going to be in the future. So the album next year. So yeah. It's been an amazing year recording together. It's been really, really nice to get back into the studio with the girls and just do the whole creative process, which is, you know, my favourite part of the business. So, yeah.
You have a message for fans before you leave us?
I just want to say thank you to all our fans who've supported us way back then, you know, when we first started out, and also all the way through the years. And now, 15 years later, they're so dedicated to us. So really, really want to thank them, because we wouldn't be here without them.
I think it's going to be a lovely, lovely evening.
You've been to the Royal Albert Hall much before. What do you think makes it such a special venue?
Yeah, I've been here numerous times. And actually, a really lovely thing is that my stepfather actually provided the fiberglass that's used in the discs in the ceiling. Yeah, the sound discs. So, yeah. So I think the London Symphony Orchestra I've seen a few times. I don't think I've seen the Royal Philharmonic, so it's going to be lovely.
What else have you been working on yourself at the moment?
I've been back on television with EastEnders, and also with another TV drama that I can't actually say what it is at the moment. And then actually looking back to going to theatre for a while.
When would you be going back on stage then?
Be towards the end of the year.
Of course, I mean, looking backwards, Broadchurch was a huge national phenomenon. How did you feel being a part of that?
It's a fabulous series. I mean, you know, it's a lovely team, great crew, creatively. It's fantastically, it's so brilliantly written. And so, yeah, it's a great thing to be part of. Lovely.
Of course, we love whenever you're back on Enders. How proud are you of the work you've been doing on that? I mean, particularly, I guess, some of the storylines, the subject matter you've been tackling, it really has meant a lot to certain people.
I love Rainey. I think she's, you know, she's just a character that there are so many difficult issues with that I enjoy tackling that, and I enjoy the challenge, and I also learn a lot from her as a character. So it's always a pleasure for me to put Rainey's shoes back on, effectively.
You say you learn a lot. What's been the biggest lesson you've taken away from playing Rainey?
I think it's really the thing of, you know, we can't, it's a big reminder that we shouldn't and can't judge people in society because they don't choose to live like we do, or because circumstantially they don't live like we do, or, you know, I live differently to somebody else and they live differently to me. And I think that society is very quick to judge people, and if anything, Rainey is a big reminder to me that judgment is really out of the equation, you know. So that's what I learned from her.
really looking forward to the concert. I think the Royal Albert Hall is probably one of the most iconic buildings in London. Absolutely love it. And to come here and listen to this standard of music is an absolute pleasure.
Of course, the Royal Philharmonic is one of our proudest assets. Have you heard them before, and how excited are you to be hearing them tonight?
I have never heard them before, and I'm super, super excited. It's just going to be a lovely, lovely evening, and I'm very, very pleased to be here.
And of course, Valeriya is an international musical icon. Are you familiar with her work, and you excited particularly to be hearing her sing tonight?
I fell asleep listening to her music last night. She's just fabulous, beautiful lady. Wonderful voice, so really looking forward to this evening. I am actually still very much a practicing NHS GP, so what I am most proud of is the way it has engaged a group of people who perhaps wouldn't naturally think about healthcare. And we are told by the NHS that we have saved them literally millions of pounds just through the website. So with my sensible GP hat on, that's what I'm most proud of. I think it's really clever the way Maverick Television make embarrassing bodies, and I think they have a very, very clever balance between that kind of slightly cheeky drawing you in with that voyeuristic thing and then educating you along the way. They are brilliant at what they do. We have a huge team behind us, and actually the people that do the really hard work are the team behind us. And a lot of those crew have stayed with us through various series, so there's a lot of expertise in knowing how to make people feel at rest, how to make people feel relaxed. But also, we are so, so lucky with the backup that we have from some of probably the best consultants in the country. So I just love being part of the team. Pixie and Christian are fantastic to work with, but it's the crew probably behind the scenes that make the big difference. I can't begin to count the people that I have seen that have really touched me. And I tell you what it is, actually, when you work in the NHS, you only see people when they're not better. And we do what we call reveal days, when we see people when they have been fixed, their physical problem has been fixed. And for me, watching those people come in, and okay, we might have dealt with a skin rash or uneven breasts or whatever it may be. For me, when they come back, looking at them, walk in, 6 inches taller with a smile on their face, usually wearing slightly different clothes, they've probably had their hair done, and it just hits you just how much that physical problem had affected their emotional well-being. And that's what I love. My NHS colleagues moan at me that when the show is on air, they reckon it generates something like 40 appointments per week per doctor. And I say I'm not apologising for that, because actually that's what it's designed to do. The whole point is we want to make sure that people don't. You know, I am a GP. I have seen people literally die of embarrassment. They've ignored a lump in their breast because they didn't want to see a doctor about it. If our show brings just one person through the door sooner, it does what it was designed to do.
Are you looking forward to the concert tonight?
I am looking forward to the concert. I don't often get to see live concert, so it'd be a nice experience.
The Royal Albert Hall is a really special space. Are you especially excited to be here for the concert tonight in this beautiful arena?
Yes, I am. It's classical music, I believe, isn't it? So, and I like classical music. It's gonna be beautiful. Really gonna be something stunning, hopefully.
Can you tell us a little bit about your outfit? It's rather stunning.
This outfit is from my school friend called Jade, and she goes under Jade Art, and she's just started a new business and she's into vintage wear. So I'm not actually sure where this is from, but possibly the 1950s.
I know you've been working with Idris Elba on 100 Streets lately. Can you tell us a little bit what that film's about and what excited you about that project?
I can't say too much about it because we've just finished it, but we've got an amazing cast. We've got Gemma Arterton, Samantha Barks, Idris Elba, who's producing and starring, and Stephen McIntosh. Basically, the list is endless, but it's filmed in Battersea. What can I say about it? All walks of life with lots of problems. That's all I can say. What, Gemma? Well, she's just amazing. She's just she's got real kind of star quality, beautiful looking, great actress. She's got it all going.
Privilege for me to be here. because it's a legendary venue, very reputable, historical. It's very exciting, you know, and I know so many people came from different countries to be here tonight with me, and I really appreciate it. And we'll be having an international team on stage as well. My band, and the first time I'll be playing with the Royal Philharmonic Concert Orchestra, conducted by Maestro Paul Bateman, and the choir, Capital Voices. They'll be singing in Russian also.
What can we expect from your set tonight? Obviously, you have a glittering body of work. What songs are you particularly excited to sing in this beautiful space?
I have very beautiful duets with my friends, with great artists, with great performers. And there'll be, I think it'll be something interesting. I'm working on the album, so maybe we'll do this the second version, I mean the version in English. Maybe. Yeah, well, thinking of it.
What continues to inspire you as an artist?
I love traveling. I love bright people. They inspire me a lot. I love life as it is. I played I traveled with, I toured with Simply Red. Yeah, I took part in his tour, English tour, or British, because we visited a lot of other places. And I participated in two gigs at the O2 Arena. It was something special. Those very, very emotional moments. And people didn't know my songs, didn't know me, and they received me. They saw me for the first time, and they received me so warmly. I really appreciate it. I love the British audience.
And of course, your songs mean so much to so many fans around the world. For you, though, which is your favorite to perform? Which gives you the most special feelings inside?
Maybe the song which brought me the first success. My first hit. I'll be singing it tonight. Along with the audience, I hope. I love you. I feel your support. I read your messages in all social nets. I'm very happy that you're with me. And I will try to not disappoint you. Thank you. Bye-bye.